रिशव, डज योर मदर स्कोल्ड यू अ लॉट? हाँ,
नो मैम.
और योर पेरेंट्स टेल यू टू स्टडी, दैट इज व्हाई स्कूल इज अ बेटर प्लेस, इज इट सो रिशव? ओके ओके, कमिंग बैक टू आवर चैप्टर टी फ्रॉम असम, दिस इज द थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ आवर चैप्टर ग्लिम्सेस ऑफ इंडिया. सो इन ग्लिम्सेस ऑफ इंडिया यू हैव थ्री पार्ट्स. द राइटर टेक्स अस शोज अस अ पेन पिक्चर ऑफ द वेरियस parts of India. First of Goan village and the Baker, then Coorg, and in the third part to the northeast, Assam. From Assam. So, describe the scenery that Rajveer saw out from the train window. Who will describe the scenery that Rajveer saw out of the train window? Hello. Class has to be interactive. Only if I keep on speaking, I also get very bored. You also have to answer. Who will answer? Sugandh is present. Sugandh.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
What kind of scenery did Rajveer see outside the train window while he was traveling to Assam? Okay, Pragya wants to answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
And there was greenery out of the window.
Yes.
And tea garden.
Okay, so he could see greenery everywhere, vast stretches of green tea gardens. Okay, so what are the two legends about the discovery of tea? Who can say? Advit, one story you say. What is one of the story, the legend about the how tea was discovered? Advit, am I audible? Hello, Advit.
Sorry, ma'am.
Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Aditya, you want to answer? What is one of the story related to the origin of tea? Aditya Raj.
Ma'am, the Chinese emperor,
yes,
boiled water before drinking it.
Okay.
Once a day, few leaves of tea were put into the water, and it gives it a delicious flavor.
Okay. Yes, Aditi, your answer is correct. A Chinese emperor, he was boiling water. And then he was using the twigs of branches as a fuel. To boil the water, he was using the small thin branches. And a few leaves from those branches accidentally fell. Haan, bolo. Nishu?
Ma'am?
Haan.
Yes, ma'am.
Nishu, you
ma'am,
want...
Rishabh Kumar hai, 10B ka. Ma'am, Rishabh Kumar hai, 10B ka. Ma'am, wo pareshan kar raha hai, number maang raha hai.
उससे
कुछ मैसेज कर रहा है.
ऋषभ, शुड आई कंप्लेन टू विनीता मैम? ऋषभ रंजन, स्टॉप डूइंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स. एवरीथिंग इज बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड. कंप्लेंट इज ऑल्सो बीइंग रिकॉर्डेड. यू कैन सी द रेड स्पॉट. रिकॉर्डिंग इज गोइंग ऑन. सो बेटर डोंट डू ऑल दीज काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स. ऋषभ, complaint has also been recorded. So,
मैम म्यूट कर दिया.
किसको म्यूट कर दिया? अपने आप को. हाँ,
मैम क्लास लीव कर दिया.
लीव कर दिया ना? हाँ, तो अभी उसको रहने दो. लीव कर दिया तो अच्छा क्या, दूसरे को डिस्टर्ब करेगा, उससे अच्छा कि लीव कर दे. सो ओके सो वन स्टोरी इज दैट द चाइनीज एम्परर वॉज बॉइलिंग वाटर एंड फ्यू लीव्स ऑफ टी फेल इन द वाटर एंड देन वेन ही ड्रैंक दैट वाटर इट गेव हिम अ डिलिशियस फ्लेवर एंड ही थॉट दैट these leaves can be used to make a delicious drink. So he started plantation of those twigs and then tea came into existence. Okay, what is the second story about the origin of tea? Who will answer? Bhavya?
Can I answer, ma'am?
Bhavya? Hello? Bhavya, am I audible to you? What is the second story related to the origin of tea? Okay. Anuj, you want to answer?
Yes, ma'am.
One story is about the Chinese emperor. What is the other legend?
The other legend is about a hermit named Bodhidharma, who was meditating and got very angry because he felt very sleepy, so he cut his eyelid and the tea leaves come out from his eyelids.
Okay, yes. The second story is about a Buddhist ascetic. He was meditating and his eyelids were creating lot of trouble for him. His eyelids were falling now and then, which disturbed him in his meditation. So he got very irritated with his eyelids. He thought, why not cut off these eyelids which are disturbing me? And he cut off those eyelids and threw it. And then what grew from those eyelids? 10 tea plants. Buddhist ascetic ne jo apna eyelid kaat ke fek diya, kyunki वो उसके मेडिटेशन में डिस्टर्बेंस क्रिएट कर रहा था और फिर उसने अपने आईलिड्स को काट के फेंक दिया एंड फ्रॉम दोज आईलिड्स 10 टी प्लांट्स ग्रियो एंड इट इज़ यूजुअली व्हाट हैपेंस व्हेन यू ड्रिंक टी इट गिव्स यू अ मोमेंट्री एनर्जी इट गिव्स यू अ मोमेंट्री एनर्जी एंड makes you less sleepy. Banish means what? Banish means keep away. Dur bhagana. Banish means to keep away. Banish also means to drive a person out of his own country. Banish matlab wo bhi hota hai. Lekin is context mein, in this context, banish means keep away. And the tea plants that grew from the eyelids of the Buddhist ascetic. What was the name of the Buddhist ascetic? What was the name of the Buddhist ascetic? Who can tell me? Let me check your concentration and your memory power.
Bodhidharma.
Yes, very good. Who answered? Srishti? Hello. Bodhidharma. That was the name of the Buddhist ascetic. An ancient Buddhist ascetic. What is the meaning of ascetic?
One who have devoted him or herself for religious work.
Yes, ascetic is a person of a religious community who renounces all the worldly things. So, a person who gives away all the worldly things and he just gets himself involved in religious activities. So, that is an ascetic. So, okay, so tea was first, where is tea said to be originated?
China.
Yes, China, as back as 27,000 BC. as back as 27,000 BC. So tea is a very old, ancient drink, and it is said to have originated in China. That is why the word chai, it is not a Hindi word. It actually, this word originated in China. Chai and chini, which we put in the tea, that also originated from China only. Tea came to Europe only in the 16th century. So originated in China as back as 27,000 BC. After that, it came in Europe in the 16th century and was drunk most. It was drunk, again Rishabh has entered. Rishabh, I'm making you enter the class, but don't do any kind of activities that is not permitted. Indisciplinary activities are not permitted. Okay, so tea came from Europe only in the 16th century and was drunk more as a medicine than as a beverage. तो पहले जो चाय पिया जाता था वो daily drink के तरह नहीं, it was drunk as a medicine occasionally. Gradually it became a daily drink, a beverage. The train clattered into the Mariami Junction. So finally the boys reached their destination, Mariami Junction. And they collected their luggage and pushed their way to the crowded platform. Who had come to receive them? Who had come to receive them? Pranjol's parents. Pranjol's parents were waiting for them. Soon they were driving towards Dhekiabari, the tea garden managed by Pranjol's father. So they were driving towards Dhekiabari, which is the tea garden managed by Pranjol's father. As we are told in the beginning of the chapter, Pranjol's father is the manager of a tea garden. In the beginning of the chapter, we are told this. An hour later, the car veered sharply. What is the meaning of veered? V-E-E-R. Yes, suddenly changed the direction. Veered means to change the direction suddenly. So the car changed the direction, suddenly veered sharply off the main road. They crossed a cattle bridge and entered Dhekiabari tea estate. So the car changed its direction and they crossed a cattle bridge. They entered the Dhekiabari tea estate. On both sides of the gravel road, gravel means small stones. On both sides of the gravel road were acre upon acre of tea bushes. So Assam is known for its tea gardens. And acres of acres of land consisted only of tea bushes and gardens, all neatly pruned to the same height. Pruned means cut. And all the tea bushes were cut to the same height, pruned to the same height. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets. And in the tea garden, you could see the bamboo, the tea pluckers. So, have you seen women plucking trees? Tea, sorry. Have you seen women plucking tea? So they keep a bamboo basket tied to their backs. A bamboo basket, एक bamboo का basket जो है वो पीठ में बंधा हुआ रहता है. And they put the tea leaves in that basket. And now they cannot simultaneously do two things, hold the basket and put the tea. Simultaneously दोनों चीज़ थोड़ा difficult हो जाएगा. तो basket को वो लोग अपने पीठ के पीछे बांध कर रखते हैं. द टी प्लकर्स दे टाई द बास्केट टू द बैक, दे डोंट हैव टू होल्ड इट, एंड देन दे पुट द टी लीव्स ऑन देयर बैक्स. वेयरिंग प्लास्टिक एप्रन्स, एंड दे वेयर एप्रन्स ऑल्सो बिकॉज टी लीव्स में स्टेन देयर क्लोथ, चाय का दाग होता है ना, इफ एक्सीडेंटली द टी फॉल्स ऑन योर क्लोथ यू विल नोटिस, इफ यू डोंट वॉश इट इमीडिएटली वॉट विल हैपन, इट विल स्टेन योर क्लोथ, यू मस्ट हैव ऑब्जर्वड इट, चाय का जो है दाग तुरंत लगता है। तो जो टी प्लकर्स होते हैं वो कपड़े में दाग नहीं लगे इसके लिए वो लोग एप्रन पहन के रखते हैं, बिकॉज टी लीव्स हैज़ अ वेरी डार्क स्टेन। ओके, सो वेयरिंग प्लास्टिक एप्रन्स वर प्लकिंग द न्यूली स्प्राउटेड लीव्स एंड दे वर प्लकिंग द फ्रेश लीव्स, द न्यूली स्प्राउटेड लीव्स, सो द टी प्लकर्स दे वर प्लकिंग द newly sprouted leaves. Okay. Pranjal's father slowed down to allow a tractor pulling a trailer load of tea leaves. So tea is transported to various other parts from Assam. So on their way, what do they see? They see a very big tractor. And what is there in that tractor? That tractor is loaded with tea leaves. Those tea leaves are probably being transported to somewhere else. On their way, they meet a tractor and that tractor is loaded with tea leaves. And Pranjal's father stops the car. He allows the tractor to pass. This is the second flush or sprouting period. Isn't it? So this is the second sprouting period. It's not that एक बार आप वो tea leaves pluck कर लेते हैं तो वो ख़त्म हो जाता है, बार बार उसमें से sprouts निकलते हैं. So now this is the second sprouting season, second time the tea leaves are coming out, second flush or sprouting period, isn't it, Mr. Barua? Rajveer asked. So before coming to Assam, Rajveer has done a lot of research on tea and he has gathered lot of information about tea. So he knows that this particular month it is the second sprouting season of the tea leaves. Rajveer asks, it lasts from May to July. Jo tea leaves ka second sprouting season hota hai, that is from May to July and yields the best tea. And which tea leaves give us the best tea? The tea leaves of the second sprouting season. तो राजवीर ने बहुत सारे information gather किया था और असम visit करने से पहले. He knows that the best tea is the tea of the second sprouting season. That gives us the best flavor. Second sprouting season and it lasts from May to July. You seem to have done your homework before coming. Pranjal's father knows that Rajveer has gathered a lot of information before coming to Assam. You have done a lot of homework before coming, Pranjal's father said. Yes, Mr. Barua, Rajveer admitted, but I hope to learn much more while I am here. So he has gathered lot of information about tea, but he has a desire to learn more facts, more and more facts about tea while I am here. While he is in Assam, he wants to gather more information about tea. So these kind of exercises though will not come. Let us see if there are question answers. No question answers. Right? So there are no question answers. Okay. So this chapter has ended, Tea from Assam, Glimpses of India. This chapter is finished. ओके सो यू वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर्स आई अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग हेलो लेट मी शेयर सम ग्रामर एक्सरसाइज स्टॉप शेयर ये किसने शेयर कर दिया डोंट डू दीज काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटीज एवरीथिंग इज बींग रिकॉर्डेड इफ यू डोंट वॉन्ट टू स्टडी यू लीव द क्लास यू आर फ्री टू लीव देर इज नो कंपल्शन दैट यू शुड बी इन द क्लास सम ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज ये तो हो गया था ना दिस वन ऑल्सो वी हैड ना दिस वन आई थिंक यू हैवन डन ये हुआ था हेलो दिस वन यू हैवन डन नो
Yes, ma'am.
चलो ये बनाते सो दिस इज ऑल्सो इनकरेक्ट एंड करेक्ट हाउ मच टाइम इज लेफ्ट 10 minutes आई थिंक वॉट एवर टाइम इज लेफ्ट चलो एक दो एक्सरसाइज तो हम कर ही सकते हैं तो CBSE में इसी तरह
का
क्या 10 minutes तो इन CBSE यू विल गेट दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्सरसाइजेज ओनली दिस एरर करेक्शन ओमिशन गैप फिलिंग ओके दिस टाइम एटलीस्ट यू आर लकी दैट CBSE हैज लेसेंड योर बर्डन फर्स्ट टर्म पोर्शन यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू गेट इन सेकेंड टर्म दैट इज अ बिग रिलीफ फॉर यू इजंट इट ओके लॉन्ग टेल्स हेल्प कैट्स टू कैप्ट देयर है तो फर्स्ट वन इज डन इफ दे रन एंड जम्प ये हुआ था कि नहीं बताओ तो हेलो प्रज्ञा हैड वी डन दिस प्रज्ञा हेलो हेलो
नो
नो मैम
नो मैम
नहीं अच्छा चलो balance if they run and jump so what is the mistake here
when
so in this when is the correct word so if is the wrong word if they run and jump if is the wrong word the correct word is when some of the big cats are so fast so what is the mistake Some of the big cats are so fast. Advit, what is the mistake in this line? Some of the big cats are so fast. Advit?
Some of the big cats.
Huh? Okay, who else wants to answer?
Ma'am, age?
I'm very fast.
Kaushal, you want to answer? Vijaya Roy? Some of the cats are so fast.
May
what? Some of the cats are so fast. What is the mistake? Kaushal Kishore?
I'm very fast, ma'am.
Yes, very fast. Very fast.
Very fast.
I also said this.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Advait, I could not hear your voice. Maybe because... Okay, Advait, so your answer is also correct if you said it. Okay. So some of the big cats are very fast. A cheetah can run for 110 kilometers an hour. What is the mistake in this sentence? Bhavya? Okay, answer. A cheetah can run for
110 kilometers.
Yes, it is the speed. So for speed, what do you use? For speed, you use the word at. So that is the mistake. So for is the wrong word. Which is the correct word? At. A cheetah can run at 110 kilometers per hour. Cats had big padded paws.
Have.
Yes. Have. Cats have. So had is the wrong word. Correct word is have. Cats have big padded paws which help them to jumping.
In.
Yes.
In.
Yes, in is the correct word. Incorrect word is to. Incorrect word is to, and instead of to, you will use in, which help them in jumping and running and reaching their prey. But in this line also there is one mistake.
T-H-E-I-R.
But no blank is given. Maybe it is a printing error. Error is there in this, but no blank is given there. Reaching their prey silently. So you can do that correction also. T-H-E-R-E is the wrong word. And the correct word is T-H-E-I-R. They have longest sharp teeth and claws.
Longest is an incorrect word.
Yes, longest is the incorrect word. Which is the correct word? They have longest.
I'm long.
Yes, they have long. They have long, sharp teeth and claws to grip and kill their prey. To grip and kill their prey. In this, there is no mistake.
There is no error.
Yes, there is no error in the seventh line. So leave it out. Claws to grip and kill their prey. Tigers are the big cats. Who will answer? Wait. Tigers are the big cats. Dhruv Pandey, you want to answer? Dhruv? Tigers are the big cats. Hello?
May I?
Okay, answer.
Tigers are the biggest cats.
Yes, the biggest cats, because the is used here, and the is used before superlatives of adjectives. We learned this in articles. Before all the superlative degrees, which article you use? The biggest, the longest, the largest, the smallest. So here also the is used. So you should have the superlative degree. The biggest cats. They live on grasslands and forests. They live on grasslands and forests. Yes. Yes. On is the incorrect word. Which is the correct word? Which is the correct word? Yes, in is the correct word. Live in grasslands and forests. Their stripes help them to hide between trees and tall grasses.
Among trees and tall grasses.
Yes, between you use just for two things. Divide the cake between the two brothers. But here there are lots of trees and lots of grasses. So, lots of trees and lots of grasses, you cannot use between. What will you use? Among. Okay. this one did we do? In India, working women lead a life. Hello? What is the mistake in the first line? In India, working women, first one is already done. First one is already done. Woman is the subject, so there should be no S in the verb. Woman is a plural subject. So the verb should be without S. Woman lead a life of dual responsibilities if they were married. Vijaya?
They are married?
Yes. If they are married and have the family. If they are married and have the family, which is the mistake?
With the family.
Yes, Kishan, you answered something.